Naresh Gujral, you've always got an incisive mind in your analysis of elections. You should be here as a, join us as a cephologist, actually. What is your reading of the Gujarat elections and its implications for the rest of the country? Looking ahead.
Pranoy, there are two messages from this election. One is the political message and one is the economic message. The political message is that this is the Prime Minister's victory, and I wouldn't call it a BJP's victory, because the Prime Minister sensed that things were not going the right way for BJP. He jumped into the fray, campaigned very vigorously, and because he enjoys credibility in Gujarat, he swung it for them. The second point is the Tina factor, that there is no alternative, is dead. Congress gave a very good fight, and today they are a credible force both in Gujarat, and I think as a result, even in the country, this would help them. Third, going forward to 2019, 15 states have to go to polls, and so does the nation. I think the era of single party dominance is over. I don't see BJP getting a full majority in 2019, primarily because there is anti-incumbency everywhere. They won in many states 26 out of 26, Gujarat 25 out of 25 in Rajasthan, 72 out of 80 in UP, and so on in many states, which I don't think is possible. Coalitions are going to again come back to rule the country. And that also means that the age of arrogance is over. Any party that does not deal with allies or prospective allies with humility and accommodates them will suffer, as we saw in Gujarat, where Rahul Gandhi, not settling with NCP, made Congress lose 7 to 8 seats.
That is actually
similarly,
an important point, yes.
Not dealing nicely with Vaghela led to his exit. So going forward, this is going to be a very important factor, that you have to deal with your allies, howsoever small they may be, with tact, with sincerity, and also be accommodating.
So Naresh,
and last, you cannot wish away 20% of the voting population, which are the minorities. You have to build bridges with them. You have to ensure that they come and vote for your coalition.
So there
this is
the
political message.
You talked about
the economic message is that the farmers are angry, as we saw in Saurashtra. They did not stand by BJP because BJP had made a certain commitment, which was to implement the Swaminathan formula. And all of us have been pressing for it, but unfortunately, they did not listen.
So, Naresh,
so you have to solve the agrarian crisis, which is there for real. But I'm very glad to say that when it comes to bringing in transformational change in the economy, be it GST or even demonetization, people have supported Mr. Modi, because the way cities have voted for BJP goes to show that they are willing to take temporary pain, but they want India to progress, and they are willing to accept this change.
Naresh, you represent an ally. In fact, you represent one of BJP's essential allies. You talked about there being no place any longer for arrogance in dealing with allies. Have you and your party felt arrogance? Have experienced arrogance while dealing with your senior partner?
I'll give you a small example. They are trying to change the name of Dayal Singh College, which is a minority institution.
In Delhi.
Dayal Singh Majithia
in Delhi
was a philanthropist. He set up the Tribune. He was an architect of Punjab National Bank. And suddenly they want to change the name of this institution to Vande Mataram College. Why pin pricks? For no reason. We've been begging them for the last 2 months that don't do that. This upsets the Sikh community, but this falls on deaf ears. So this is how what I'm saying, small irritations will lead to a crisis later on.
And allies have the sense that the senior partner doesn't listen to us or doesn't care.
Well, unfortunately, not just the allies, even the BJP MPs feel the same way.
Wow, that's a very candid confession of
very strong words from you, Naresh. You
know, that's an angry ally, I can see.
There are as many as 49 parties in NDA today. And you yourself said not every one of them is feeling like that. Of course, there could be pinpricks, but don't you agree that the BJP has been able to manage coalition much better,
Chari,
be it Vajpayee's time or be it Modi's time.
Chari, can I ask you the same question?
Then the Congress.
That you are asking him, the reaction of the Shiv Sena to this today is the Gujarat results has been very negative for the BJP. Very negative.
But,
I mean, they've been critical.
You should go into the background of Shiv Sena losing badly to the Congress. And causing up to the BJP and causing up to Sharad Pawar.
So no, but you're just saying you're good at handling allies. Yeah. They were one of your solid
oldest
allies.
Your oldest ally, prolonged your oldest ally.
These were the essential allies. That's
but right. They have lost elections, and that is one of the reasons why they are blaming it on the BJP instead of doing introspection.
But Mr. Gujral, can I ask you, do you feel that Mr. Narendra Modi, you mentioned that he is this larger-than-life figure, he's the chief vote catcher, he is, you know, he is a kind of 21st century Indira Gandhi in a way. He is sort of dominates his party, dominates the government, it's a kind of one-man show. Do you believe that he is someone who can't build consensus with allies? Do you feel that he's someone who's uncomfortable with allies, that he tends to impose his own will on allies? Is he the wrong kind of leader to reassure the allies?
Well, I think BJP needs a Vajpayee touch. If you want to have a rainbow coalition, you have to treat everybody equally. You have to treat your allies with more respect. And I'm sure this is a wake-up signal. And I'm sure they'll adjust to it. But as I said earlier, that going up to 2019, allies will ensure which side forms the government.
So if you're saying you need the Vajpayee touch, what should the BJP's approach be to Ayodhya? Should they change?
I would say let sleeping dogs lie.
And one last question. Again, I think you've lived up to a true analytical mind and a better cephologist than the one sitting next to me on my left. there's a lot of talk that the Lok Sabha elections may be brought forward to be simultaneous with Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh and others. Do you think that's going to happen? We could have Lok Sabha elections next year?
I can't guess about that. I have no information. Your guess is as good as mine. But as I said, going forward, it is important for both sides to deal with allies or prospective allies, give them the dignity, give them the space, and deal with them with humility.
Right, Naresh Gujral, thank you very, very much for joining us.